Good evening. My name is Dr. DeLongo, and welcome to Talking with the Witches. Today we will be talking about why Mr. Hale quit the court, and why Abigail accused Elizabeth of witchcraft, and why Proctor didn't sign his confession. To better understand these events, we will be talking with John Proctor, the man with a plan who is trying to settle down with his family. Next, we will be talking to Abigail Williams, who not only got half the village killed, but didn't know what she was getting into. Finally, we will talk to Mr. Hale, a good man that worships the good Lord above. Amen. May I first start off by saying, how's it hanging, bro? Okay, but on a serious note, why don't you just sign your name to the confession? You could be freed, and you won't have to worry about the gallows.
I'll not have my name tied to a piece of paper that belittles it more and more every second it is on there. That is not who I am as a person, and I will not be remembered for years to come as a male witch of Salem.
I can see your point, but you would have a lifetime to change what the paper says about you. Make yourself look like a better man after that.
Signing that paper would ruin the man you see before you in my eyes. I'd rather die than to have my name on that paper posted on the church.
You are a proud man, John Proctor. It is really a shame that this is what brought down to you in this manner.
Well, this could have been avoided if that whore of Salem would just let me live my life happily.
You are referring to Abigail?
Of course. The word whore fits her description quite well, if I do say. I wouldn't be surprised if there are men throwing coin at her from all angles.
What do you think about Abigail as a person?
Pure evil. There is not much I can say to defend a person of her nature. Anyone who would interrupt someone's happiness for their own personal gain is not a person in my eyes. I have no respect.
Thank you, John, for coming here and speaking your mind the way you have. Our next guest is a real troublemaker and making everybody paranoid and killing off other people. Please give a round of applause for the true witch of Salem, Abigail Williams. We brought John Proctor out here first so he could fill us in on some trauma that he has experienced, and it all seems to be centered around you.
He likes to blame all of his life issues on me. It's not my fault that his wife used one of his dolls to hurt me, and that I informed the town of him being a witch.
You truly believe that this is what has befallen you?
Yes, I was targeted by Elizabeth because she knew of the paths that John and I held. In reaction to me informing the court that what Elizabeth had done, John took up witchcraft to further attack for revenge.
John seemed very sincere of not practicing witchcraft and was more worried about how the town would look at him if he admitted to it. He knows if he does, his name will be ruined.
John is a liar. He can make anyone believe anything he says. His name is already ruined in my eyes.
As a result of this, you think having him hanged is the solution?
Are you disagreeing with me on my duty to cleanse Salem of witches? Are you defending them? Are you one of them?
I did not say that I was agreeing with anyone. I am a non-biased party.
Well, you should side with the ones that are trying to better the world by getting rid of these monsters.
All right, on to another subject. How do you feel about being called the town whore?
Well, you see, that's nothing new. People always talk and believe what they want. I just push it aside.
This doesn't bother you?
Why would it? I know who I am. People don't hurt me. I'm the savior of Salem.
Well, by the way people talk about you, it doesn't seem like they see you as a savior of Salem.
You are siding with them. I'm done with this. You better watch yourself, Dr. DeLongo.
Well, that was Abigail for you. Last but not least is Mr. Hale. He is a godly man that worships the Lord. He is trying to make sense of all of this and why people are killing each other. Hello, John Hale. You seem to be having a hell of a time in Salem.
You have no idea. It's just too much to handle when all of you have is good intentions to help the town. You start doubting the accusers, but at the same time, you feel as if you can't trust the accused.
We were informed that you did quit the court. What caused you to take such a drastic action?
Well, to be quite frank, I found the court was constantly siding with the accusers without solid evidence that the accused were guilty. I could not be a part of the innocent dying any longer. John Proctor, in my eyes, was not a liar and a great man, which made me doubt all the accusations done by Abigail and the others.
At the time, you even visited the accused and tried to get them to sign the paper confessing to witchcraft. Is this true?
It is, but all were too proud to put their name on the paper, in which case they will all hang because of their pride. I can't help but respect their choices, even if it means they will be hanged for it.
You entirely think that all the accused are innocent?
As to what I've seen, the only witch in my sight is Abigail, anyone that can do with more remorse for any family and friends that have lost someone dear to them is a real witch in my eyes.
Do you think she believes what she is saying is the truth?
I can't help but think she is a pathological liar and actually think that what she is doing is right, is the right thing. But the benefit of the doubt is, in my opinion.
What do you mean by that?
There's always the possibility, in my opinion, that she is just pure evil and that she knows this is the wrong thing to be doing, but yet she doesn't care and keeps it going for her own pleasure.
Do you think there is any helping her, Mr. Hale?
I think the only way to help her is to have her end up as the innocent that were murdered in her name.
Thank you, Mr. Hale. Well, as you can see, three people came to the talk show today, and the only one that sides with Abigail is herself. Thank you for coming to Talking to the Witches, and goodbye.